Welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for the segment of Monmouth in Focus. Today we're joined by County Surrogate Rosemarie Peters to talk about the 2017 My County Poster Contest. Thanks so much for joining us here on Monmouth in Focus.
You're welcome. I'm so happy to be here to talk about something that's fun, because the surrogate's office mostly deals with things that aren't so happy.
Absolutely.
So this is one of our happy things.
Yeah, it's that time of year again, the My County Poster Contest. Let's talk about what it is.
This poster contest is run under the auspices of a state organization called the Constitutional Officers Association, which is made up of county clerks, sheriffs, and surrogates, mm-hmm. and registers of deeds in some counties. Every year the organization runs a poster contest, which is run separately in each county, because the whole point of the contest is to focus on the county.
Yes.
So each county runs its own, and it's for fourth grade students, because in the spring of that year, most students are focusing on government in New Jersey, and county government would be included in that. So it's part of the curriculum, but it also gives them an opportunity to translate what they're learning into an art project.
Sure. I think it's such a great program, great event. So I'm sure there are some rules that the fourth graders have to follow, correct?
Some rules. It has to be on 22 by 28 poster mm-hmm. board. It has to have the name of the county in nice large letters in black marker at the top. They have to have the name of their school, their teacher, and their name on the back of the poster. And the reason for that is that these are judged blind. When they're judged, the judges, who are the clerk, the sheriff, and the surrogate,
correct.
Don't want to know who the student is,
right.
which school they go to,
mm-hmm.
So that we can judge each one on its own merit.
And it's fourth grade students from public and private schools?
Correct. Any school in the county that has a fourth grade receives an invitation to participate.
Right, absolutely. And how many do you receive? You must receive hundreds?
It varies tremendously. Some years we receive hundreds, some years we receive less than that.
Mm-hmm.
But generally the ones that come in are wonderful.
And like you said, it's a county event, so they have to focus on Monmouth County. So much to focus on here, from the parks to the beaches to just the towns, the uniqueness of the county. What are some of the posters that come to mind over the years that you've really thought were spectacular?
Generally, what makes a poster great in my mind is that the student has processed what they've learned and come up with an idea that's unusual or original, and then created art around that concept.
Hmm.
It's like any good poster. It's mm-hmm. got to be eye-catching, it's got to be well executed, but there has to be a theme or an idea behind it that is different. We just see so much in our lives. I mean, we're exposed to so much of a visual nature. So for something to stop you in your tracks, it's got to have something special. And so that's
right.
what we're always looking for. We get some that are beautifully executed, but
sure.
they're just pretty pictures.
Right.
But every once in a while you find one where they've focused maybe on the parks or maybe on law enforcement, but they've done it in such a way that it stands out from the pack.
It kind of tells a story.
It tells a story,
yeah.
correct.
Yeah.
yeah.
Now, so once the posters are submitted, then the judges, like we said, that they're constitutional officers, the sheriff, the clerk, and the surrogate, they come together, they judge the posters, and then what?
Well, then there are three prizes of some worth mm-hmm. that go to the first, second, and third place winner. Then there are 9 honorable mentions.
Wow.
And each one is displayed in a county administration building for 1 month.
Right.
So they get a little exposure for
sure.
their work. And for a fourth grader, I think that's really
that's
something
great.
Special.
That's
and
great.
I think their
Probably
parents are
makes them feel
very
good
proud
too.
Of them.
And
absolutely.
I know in the past the constitutional officers have visited the schools.
We generally visit
yeah.
all of the schools to present the prizes to them
mm-hmm.
in person.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes the school will have an assembly and take pictures. And, it's really, for a fourth grader, it's something special.
And obviously not every single fourth grader participates. It's up to the teachers to assign this, or is it up to the students or the parents?
We've seen them come in both ways. Sometimes we'll get everybody in the classroom is given the assignment, so we'll get a whole class full of posters. Other times the parents will spot the information and they'll get their child to do it and then they'll bring it in themselves. So it really kind of doesn't matter how it gets to us as long as it does.
Yeah, it is a great idea though to make that part of a curriculum.
Yeah, I think so many people are unaware of how big and varied Monmouth County is. And especially children, if their parents aren't taking them to different places around the county, they focus more on their immediate surroundings.
Sure.
But by having to look at the county as a whole and the fact that we have beaches and we have farms and we have such a variety of places and it's a very exciting county.
Yeah, what a way to learn
about the county. Because it is so varied and so beautiful.
Yep, great way to learn about the county. Yeah. Thank you so much for sharing that information
with us
here on Monmouth in Focus today. That is all the time we have. And of course, for more information about the My County Poster Contest, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott.